Brooklands Radio presents Surrey Business Affairs with Jackie Mitchell.
Hello and welcome to Surrey Business Affairs with me, Jackie Mitchell. We'll be covering subjects relating to business, the challenges facing businesses in the area, as well as new opportunities and innovations. And Carolyne Cross, Principal, Isis Beauty Academy, another winner of the Elmbridge Independent Retailer of the Year Awards. So I'd like to introduce our first guest. Hello there, Carolyne, and how are you today?
I'm very well, Jackie. Thank you for inviting me.
Well, thanks for joining us. So many congratulations on winning this award. How did you feel to win?
Delighted, absolutely delighted. We really didn't expect to win at all, but obviously the votes went in from our students that obviously put the votes in and people that have been involved in ISS Beauty Academy, and yes, it happened, so we were thrilled, absolutely thrilled.
Yes, because they're quite different, these awards, aren't they, because it is the consumers who are actually voting for you.
It is, and you don't have any control whatsoever, so really we just put out a note saying that we're going to, you know, we want to go in for it. If anybody would like to put our names forward or make any recommendations or comments about how they have been when they came and trained at the Academy. And we have no idea how many people voted for us. We just obviously found out that we won, which was wonderful.
Absolutely, yes. And so do you think these sorts of awards are very important for your business?
They really are. I think I was really quite surprised, actually, when we did win the award, the amount of emails and comments we got from people that know us saying congratulations. So that's more than anything we've had before. So there is some real prestige about doing this. And I would certainly encourage any other business just to go for it, because you never know.
Because you also won another award, haven't you, which is the Grade 1 Outstanding from Ofsted.
Yes, we did. Well, we're a private beauty therapy training academy in Walton, but we also deliver apprenticeship qualifications or apprenticeship courses for young ladies from 16 upwards who want to go into beauty therapy. And that's quite a new thing for us. And obviously Ofsted were there. It opens up to Ofsted inspections, and they came along in true Ofsted style. We had one day's notice and they were on the doorstep. But we embrace these kind of visits because it really shows that we're doing things right. And actually, if we were not doing something incorrect or needed guidance, they're there for that as well. So we were absolutely thrilled to get that result, because as a teacher myself, I know how hard it is to prepare for an Ofsted inspection. You never know what's going to happen. And we were absolutely thrilled. I was very proud of my team, I can say.
And so how long now have you been running these apprenticeships?
The apprenticeships have been going for about 2 years. We're in our third year, and it's going from strength to strength. It's for beauty therapy. Apprenticeships are not new, but they're not often thought of as much as they are with hairdressing. There's a very slightly different format. So we put together a program and we work with a funding agency, and it's really grown from strength to strength. And it gives these students that maybe don't want to stay into education until they're 18, which they have to, they can come out of school and choose to do the apprenticeship route, which is still considered a sort of an educational route. It's an employer-led qualification. So they are getting this valuable training at the academy in a private environment. So they're not in an FE college, which a lot of students don't want to continue there. But at the same time, they're in full-time employment. So they're earning some money as well. So, you know, they're earning while they're learning. It's setting them up for the future, and it's giving this valuable experience that future employers look for.
That sounds really good. So tell us a bit about the Academy then. When did it start?
Yes, well, it feels like forever, and it's not. But the Academy started in 2008, so it's been running for a little while. It started off originally just as a small one-room training room. We have since moved premises. We now have three training rooms. We have two other academies. We have programs running within secondary schools where we are looking to deliver the GCSE, new beauty therapy and hairdressing qualification, which is very new, and that starts at 14 and goes upwards. It gives them a fantastic career path. So it has really gone from strength to strength. We deliver private NVQ, VRQ qualifications along with apprentices, which I've just obviously mentioned. Mm. And it's just one of those places where the environment is much more sort of more intimate. You know, you have a class size between sort of 8 to 10 in a class. So it creates that much more of an intimate learning environment, which again is really, you know, a lot of students do prefer.
Yes, absolutely, because it's rare in some cases not to have that sort of very small number, isn't
absolutely
it?
In the FE colleges you're probably looking at 20 to 30 in a class. I mean, they're much bigger, but one of the reasons I started the Academy is that I really wanted that training there to be available. It isn't just about 16-year-olds. The Academy originally was about actually asking, you know, encouraging sort of mature learners that, you know, people don't necessarily stay in the same career nowadays. They may chop and change. And that's what beauty therapy has been about. And, you know, a lot of people do want to get into beauty therapy. It's a very, very lucrative business to be in. And so we've had a lot of mature learners coming in. And, you know, we do these courses to fit around people's lifestyle. So we run weekend courses, we run evening classes, but we fundamentally run only professional recognized government qualifications. I'm very passionate about that because I'll know what will give them the starting point and give them that future career that they want.
So for a lot of people then going to the academy, they're actually changing careers. So the academy is helping them to forge a new career.
Absolutely. And we've got some wonderful success stories, some are very emotional success stories, and that really is our reward because, you know, you have a student that may come in who's very shy and very quiet. Let's say a mature student, a woman that's probably been working at home with her children or been at home with her children. The children are growing up. She realises she wants to do something. She's always been interested in maybe nails or beauty therapy in general and found us, come to see us. Maybe not much confidence there. And to see them sort of start to gain that confidence back is wonderful. And then they've gone and opened up their own businesses. And it can be from a salon. It can be from working from home. It can be setting up a studio in the back of their gardens. We've got therapists that have gone off and working on cruise ships. So it really is. I get very excited about it, Jackie, because I love hearing all these, you know, these stories from our past students, which is wonderful.
And what tends to be the most popular course? Because, I mean, you do things, all sorts of things, Indian head massage, nail art, manicure, sports massage.
Yeah, there's basically three kind of routes that we find that students choose. You can either be more of a holistic, so in other words, they may choose to go through the massage route where they'll be doing Indian head, hot stones, aromatherapy, that kind of thing, or they may choose to go through the nails, or you've got your traditional beauty therapy route, which is probably a more of our popular one, where a student will come along and they will learn the whole qualifications at level 2 and level 3 to become a fully qualified beauty therapist, which encompasses it all. But we also run sports massage courses at the school, which are proving to be very popular. We do level three and level 4, and we have some connections with the Harlequins where we send some of our students along to do their case studies and assignments with. So there's courses for everybody, really. One of the things that we do at the school is if somebody's interested, we say come and see us. We always think it's so important to come and see the school.
Sure.
Tell us what your vision is. And wherever their vision is, we will work backwards with them and put them on that right path. Now, it can be maybe they don't really know what course they want to do, so we can guide them in the direction. But they may not want to be able to come, they may want to do an evening class or a weekend class. So we kind of try and put together something that's going to fit around their lifestyle and give them a plan so that they can progress and reach their final goal.
And then, of course, you also help them, don't you, to get a job afterwards?
We do.
They don't just stop the course and that's it, sort of thing.
No, they don't. Because, you know, when you finish a course, it's like, what now? You know, you've got those skills. How do I go about and move into the next phase? We have very strong links with some local employment agencies. We've got a link with a company called For Leisure Recruitment, which are an agency that come into the academy and speak to the students about their next steps, about finding jobs. We have an awful lot of salons contact us looking for staff. And the apprenticeship route is always a fantastic route because they can take an apprentice on. They do actually get some funding from that, actually. So that's always a bit of a bonus. But we are building up such a good reputation in the area of the level of standard of our therapists that a lot of salons contact us directly and say, do you have any students that have just qualified or near the end that you could perhaps recommend? So, yeah, we do. And I don't just not want to, we don't just want to sort of see them go. We want to hear about how they're doing. So we do get calls and we do get emails and say this is happening, or they'll ring up for a bit of advice. And that's lovely.
Well, that's fantastic. And so what qualification would they need to have to start their own business?
Well, professional qualifications for a start. So they need to make sure that they are gaining government NVQ, VRQ qualifications. Because one, that is giving you the correct skills to be able to go and be successful. It also will enable you to become a member of a membership organisation and get the valid insurance that you need. And employers recognise that. And also local boroughs, local sort of areas will recognise that they've got the correct qualifications. If I had a therapist that wanted to go and work in, for example, in a care home, they do need to make sure, or a hospice, they need to make sure they've got the correct qualifications behind them, so they really know what they're doing if they're working on these clients who may be a little bit more vulnerable. So it's absolutely key that they get the correct starting point with the right qualifications.
Sure, okay. And is there a particular season, in particular month, that's more busy than any others?
Well, we're actually a roll-on, roll-off programme, so we don't have a traditional September start. Although September is always our busiest time, because I think everybody recognises that's the time when you naturally want to start a new course. And January as well, because people probably have the Christmas and the New Year, you know, New Year, new start. But we are a roll-on, roll-off programme, so we are running throughout the year. But I would say those are probably our most popular times.
Okay, right. And then you're also chair of the two leading beauty organisations, BabTac and SibTac.
I am. I'm actually immediate past chair now, so I've actually stepped down from chairmanship, but I am still very much involved and I'm now immediate past chair. So BabTac stands for the British Association of Beauty Therapists and Cosmetologists. It's one of the oldest membership organisations that's been around. I've been very proud to have been part of that and still part of that. They're a membership organisation that offer insurance as well. And they're very much involved about what's going on in the industry, the current trends, about regulation. That's something that's very passionate to my heart, is actually making this industry regulated. It a lot of people will be surprised to hear that actually we're not, and it's moving forward to make sure that, you know, we, that your, the members are aware of what's happening in the industry. And SibTac is another organization, but it's an exam board. It's another exam board out there, which is more of an international exam board. So again, it's about education.
And what do you do for these various bodies?
We go along and we either represent them at certain events. We will go along, and I'm very much involved in judging for different awards. It's really representing the industry. So whatever's happening out there, I mean, last year I was very much involved with this Bruce Keogh review regarding the PIP implants and the injectables. So we are the voice of our industry. So I was very privileged to be involved in that and to actually let them know what we do and who we are.
Okay, that's great. Well, unfortunately, we've run out of time, but thank you very much for coming in, Carolyne.
My pleasure.
Now, could you give us your website address in case that people want to get some more information? You're based in Walton-on-Thames.
We are. We're based in Walton-on-Thames next to Barclays Bank, and our web address is www.isisbeautyacademy.co.uk.
Right, well, thank you very much for coming in.
Thank you.
Right, that was Carolyne Cross from Isis Beauty Academy.
Surrey Business Affairs. For and about local businesses in Surrey. Brooklands Radio.
I've been pulled way down to the lowest place. I've been lied to, shamed, I have been disgraced. Been excommunicated from every holy place. I've been beat up and robbed, I've been left for dead. For the way I look, for the things I said. When trouble thinks it's found us, the world falls down around us. I promise, baby, you won't ever feel this pain. Yes, I will say. Shot for holes. I've been